أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، respected brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today is a critically important halqa. We're going to go over one ayah and one hadith. As we mentioned last week, that there are types of people that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam cursed. And unfortunately, a lot of the Muslims fall in these types of sins. Knowingly or unknowingly. We mentioned a couple of them, and today, inshallah, we just going to remind ourselves, inshallah, so we are aware and we don't fall into these types of sins, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, and we are safe from the cursing of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And these are, these lists of these types of people are collected from a hadith on sayings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and from the Quran as well. So Shaykh rahimahullah Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyah listed tons of these types of people. So he said that لَعَنَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الْمُخَنَّثِينَ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ وَالْمُتَرَدِّلَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ. لَعَنَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مَنْ ذَبَحَ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ. So the Prophet was sort of cursed those who change their looks, those who are men but they act like women, and the women like they act like men. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also cursed the one who slaughter for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this, we see this stuff rampant in our Muslim countries and communities and wherever you go. See people slaughtering for righteous, Muslims that pray five times a day. But because of ignorance of the deen, you will go and slaughter for a righteous person that died years ago, centuries ago maybe. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cursed the one who cursed his father or his mother. And the one who deceives a blind person on the way to make fun of him and lead him to fall into a pit or a hole or trip or whatever. Sometimes we say, how would a person curse his father or her father or his mother or her mother? So the Prophet explained it. So he says, I said to him, that one of you would curse someone's father, and that person in return would curse his father. And one of you would curse someone's mother, and that person in return would curse his mother or her mother.
That's how you curse your own father, by cursing someone else, and he would return that to you. The Prophet ﷺ cursed those who are excessively visiting the graves. The women who excessively visit the grave. And the Prophet ﷺ cursed as well someone who ruins the relationship between a wife and the husband, or a person and his servant, employee, or slave. The Prophet ﷺ also cursed a woman that made her husband upset, and he spent the whole night upset with her, for legitimate reasons, of course. He has legitimate reasons, but she made him upset, and she disobeyed him. The angels would curse that woman until the morning. This is based on the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam cursed the one who claims that he is the son of such and such while he is not. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that the angels would curse someone who is pointing with a sharp piece of metal, pointing at his brother or sister at her sister, even jokingly. The angels would curse that person until they put it down. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam cursed the one who cursed the Sahaba. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam cursed those who bribe, or who take bribery, or they are the intermediary between the person who gives the bribe and the person who takes it. And don't tell me that Muslims don't bribe, don't take bribe. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam لعن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رجل يلبس لبسة المرأة والمرأة تلبس لبسة الرجل. The Prophet cursed the man who dresses like a woman and the woman who dresses like a man. So these are types of people that the Prophet cursed because of the sin that they are committing. And that does not mean that they are kicked out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it means that they are in danger until they repent. The Prophet is unpleased or displeased with them until they repent and go back to what they are supposed to go to. And this, subhanAllah, these are the results of the sins. The results of the sins. From the results of the sins, or the impact, or the negative impact of the sins as well, the person will be deprived from the du'a of the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the angels to make du'a for the believing man and the believing woman. And that a sinful person will be deprived from this. So listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشَ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهُ يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا فَاغْفِرْ لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَاتَّبَعُوا سَبِيلَكَ وَقِهِمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ رَبَّنَا وَأَدْخِلْهُمْ جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم وقهم السيئات. Beautiful dua. Beautiful dua. Extremely important. That is made by the angels, but it's only granted that the believing man and the believing woman will repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that those who are around the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who are carrying the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who are around it, yusabbihuna, the glorifying and praising their Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they believe in Him. At the same time, وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, and they are seeking forgiveness for those who believe. ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما. Oh Allah, your knowledge and your mercy has encompassed everything. فاغفر للذين. Because of that, oh Allah, forgive those who repent. للذين تابوا. And follow your path. The path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, protect them from the punishment of the hellfire. Oh Allah, admit them in Jannati Adn, the heavens of Aden. And الَّذِي وَعَدْتَهُمْ, that you promised them. وَمَنْ صَلَحَ مِنْ آبَائِهِمْ, and the righteous of their parents. وَأَزْوَاجِهِمْ, and the righteous of their spouses. وَذُرِّيَاتِهِمْ, and the righteous of their kids, which means a family together. You're not making dua just for that person, but also he would be interceding for his or her parents. They would be interceding for their spouses, and they would be interceding for their kids, because they repented and went back and took the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And more, رَبَّنَا وَأَدْخِلْهُمْ جَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ الَّتِي وَعَدْتَهُمْ, the jannah, the paradise that you promised them. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Oh Allah, you are the Almighty, the All-Wise. And وَقِهِمُ السَّيِّئَةِ. Oh Allah, protect them from evil or evil acts. So, oh Allah, forgive them, protect them from the hellfire, and admit them into Jannah that you promised them, and admit their parents, their spouses, their kids with them as well, and protect them from evil acts. Who are they? Those who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stay on His path. They don't sin. They don't sin intentionally, and they strive to stay on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the dua of those angels for those who follow the path of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they choose no path but the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As-sirat al-mustaqim, the straight path, path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, who has a chance in this dua? Not the sinful people, not the sinners.
Shame.
Those who are committed sins and stick into the sins and staying upon the sin, they have no share in this dua. That is made by the angels. And remember that. لا يعصون الله أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. Then the angels, they don't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ever. And they are always doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands them to do. So they don't disobey Allah, and they always do what Allah commands them to do. And when they make dua, their dua, of course, for someone who does not sin, his dua is guaranteed accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So their dua is accepted by Allah, guaranteed accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, and this dua is only for those who are righteous, stick to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and avoid the sins. Now we move on, that's the grief. Now we move on to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that I promised to talk. And this hadith is collected by Bukhari rahimahullah and Sahih al-Bukhari. And it's a long hadith, but it will show us a lot. Will guide us to a lot. Will benefit us a lot. من حديث سمرة بن جندب قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مما يكثر أن يقول لأصحابه هل رأى أحد منكم البارحة رؤيا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to ask his companions a lot. Did anyone of you saw a dream last night? فيقص عليه من شاء الله أن يقص. So The companions, those who saw a dream, they will narrate it to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet would interpret it. وَإِنَّهُ قَالَ لَنَا ذَاتَ غَدَى. And one day, mid-morning, he told us, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he had a dream. And the dream of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is wisdom for us and guidance for us and pretty much revelation for us. So he says, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, إِنَّهُ أَتَانِ اللَّيْلَةَ آتِيَانِ وَإِنَّهُمَا ابْتَعَثَانِ وَإِنَّهُمَا قَالَ لِي قَالَ لِي. So last night, two creations came to me, two angels came to me, and he woke me up, and he took me. He told me, انطلق وإني انطلقت معهما. Let's go. They told him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, let's go. And I went with them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وإنا أتينا على رجل مضطجع وإذا آخر قائم عليه بصخرة وإذا هو يهوي بالصخرة لرأسه فيثلب رأسه فيتدهده الحجر ها هنا فيتبع الحجر فيأخذه فلا يرجع إليه حتى يصح رأسه كما كان ثم يعود عليه فيفعل به مثل ما فعل في المرة الأولى. قال قلت لهما سبحان الله ما هذان؟ قال لي انطلق. First part of the hadith. First portion. The Prophet ﷺ was taken by these two people. These two creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or these two angels. So, in his dream, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in what he saw. So he said that I went with them, and we went until we found a man lying there. Kind of like sleeping. And then another person, standing with a boulder in his hands. Over the man who is lying down. And then he grabbed that boulder and dropped it on the head of that person who is lying down, who is sleeping. The head of that person crushes, so destroys his head. And then the boulder will roll. The one who is standing, he will follow the boulder. And before he reaches the boulder and bring it back, the head of that person who was lying will go back to the normal state. And then he will do the same thing again. He will crush his head with that boulder. The boulder will roll over. He will go and get it. Before he comes back, the head will come back again, and he will crush it continuously. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Subhanallah, glory be to Allah. Who are these two? Those two angels told him, let's go. He did not answer his question, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until the end. فَانْطَلَقَا فَأَتَيْنَا فَانْطَلَقْنَا. So we went together. فَأَتَيْنَا عَلَى رَجُلٍ مُسْتَلْقٍ لِقَفَاهِ وإذا آخر قائم عليه بكلوب من حديد وإذا هو يأتي أحد شقي وجهه فيشرشر شدقه إلى قفاه ومنخاه إلى قفاه وعينه إلى قفاه ثم يتحول إلى الجانب الآخر فيفعل به مثل ما فعل بالجانب الأول فما يفرغ من ذلك الجانب حتى يصح ذلك الجانب كما كان ثم يعود عليه فيفعل مثل ما فعل في المرة الأولى. قال قلت سبحان الله ما هذان؟ فقال لي انطلق. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. So the Prophet said we moved on until we found a man lying on his back, his head down, his face up. Another person with a plier in his hand, metal plier. And this person would open this part of the mouth of this person, he will cut it until the throat, until the back of the neck. Then he will go to his nose and he will cut it all the way to the other side. And he will go to his eyes and he will cut it all the way to the other side. And then he will switch to the other side, like the right side or left side, whatever. And he will do the same thing. And before he finished this side will go back to the normal state. And we will know at the end of the hadith why. Why is this happening? And we'll see that this is happening because of us, because of what we are doing. And we may find ourselves doing stuff like this, that causes this type of punishment. Allah protects. And then they told him, let's go. He said, the Prophet said same thing. Subhanallah, ma hadha. Glory be to Allah. Who are these two? And they will tell him, let's go. فَانْطَلَقْنَا فَأَتَيْنَا عَلَى مِثْلِ التَّنُّورِ وَإِذَا فِيهِ لَغَةٌ وَأَصْوَاتٌ. So we went until we find like an oven. And inside the oven there are a lot of tandooris, like the round oven within, like the pizza oven. The round and the slab of the fire is inside and it's burning hot. So he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until we found an oven, and inside it there was a lot of noise. Human beings noise. وَإِذَا فِيهِ لَغَةٌ وَأَصْوَاتٌ قَالَ فَاطَّلَعْنَا فِيهِ فَإِذَا فِيهِ رِجَالٌ وَنِسَاءٌ عُرَاتٌ وَإِذَا هُمْ يَأْتِيهِمْ لَهَبٌ مِنْ أَسْفَلَ مِنْهُمْ فَإِذَا أَتَاهُمْ ذَلِكَ اللَّهَبُ ضَوْضَوْا فَقَالَ قُلْتُ مَنْ هَؤُلَاءِ قَالَ لِي انطلق. So until we reached that stove and that oven and we looked, and we saw that the inside it there were men and women, naked, and like flames, they come from under them. And when those flames come under them, they start screaming because of the heat. They start screaming. So I said, "Who are these?" He told me, "Let's go." قال فانطلقنا فأتينا على نهر أحمر مثل الدم. فإذا في النهر رجل سابح يسبح وإذا على شط النهر رجل قد جمع عنده حجارة كثيرة وإذا ذلك السابح يسبح ما يسبح ثم يأتي ذلك الذي قد جمع عنده الحجارة فيفغر له فاه فيلقمه حجرا فينطلق فيسبح ثم يرجع إليه كلما رجع إليه فغر له فاه فألقمه حجرا قلت لهما ما هذان قال لي انطلق. So I moved with them until we reached a river that is red like blood, and in that river there is a man swimming, and on the side of the shore of that river there is a man with a pile of rocks. So this person who is swimming, who will come to that man, will have the pile, huge pile of rocks. And whenever he comes to him, he will open his mouth, the man will put rocks in his mouth, and he will go swimming. He will swim until the end, he comes back, and he continuously do that. Whenever he comes back, he fill his mouth with rocks, and he will swim in that river that is red, like blood. I asked, and he told me, let's go. فانطلقنا فأتينا على رجل كريه المرآة كأكره ما أن ترى إن رجلا مرأة وإذا هو عنده نار يحشها ويسعى حولها قال قلت لهما ما هذا قال لي انطلق. So we moved on until we saw a man, and he is the ugliest thing that you ever see. Very ugly person. And he was like fueling a fire. Fueling a fire, and he's taking care of that fire, and he's going around it. And asked him, who is this? He said, let's go. فانطلقنا فأتينا على روضة معتمة فيها من كل نور من نور الربيع وإذا بين ظهراني الروضة رجل طويل لا أكاد أرى رأسه طولا في السماء وإذا حول الرجل من أكثر ولدان رأيتهم قط قال قلت لهما ما هذا وما هؤلاء قالا لي انطلق انطلق.
So we went, continued our trip, until I saw a man, extremely tall man, that I couldn't see his head because of his height. And around him, a lot of little kids, little babies, playing around him. And I asked him, who is this and who are these? He said, let's go.
فانطلقنا فأتينا إلى دوحة عظيمة. لم أرى دوحة قط أعظم منها ولا أحسن.
And we continued walking until we find like a garden.
And I haven't seen a beautiful garden, a big garden like that.
قال لي ارق فيها فارتقينا فيها إلى مدينة مبنية بلبن ذهب ولبن فضة. So they told me, go up. So we went up in that garden until we found a house that is built out of gold. A brick of gold and a brick of silver. A brick of gold and a brick of silver. Beautiful house.
قال فأتينا باب المدينة فاستفتحنا ففتح لنا فدخلناها.
So we came to the door and we asked for the door to be open and it was open for us and we entered.
فتلقانا رجال شطر من حلق من خلقهم كأحسن ما أنت رائن وشطر منهم كأقبح ما أنت رائن.
And when we came in, we found people, half of them is so nice and beautiful. And half of them is ugly.
قال لهم اذهبوا فقعوا في ذلك الناس.
So they looked at those men, those two that took the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. They looked at those men, half of them is handsome, nice, and beautiful, and the other half is ugly. Go to that river and jump into it.
قال وإذا نهر معترض يجري كأنه ماء المحس في البياض
with water like beautiful as milk.
فذهبوا وقعوا فيه.
So they dipped themselves into the river.
ثم رجعوا إلينا وقد ذهب ذلك السوء عنه.
So they came back without any ugly part in them.
قال لي هذه جنة عدن وهذاك منزلك.
So they said, this is Aden, paradise or garden, and that's your abode or your house, to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال فسمى بصري صعودا فإذا قصر مثل الربابة البيضاء.
So I looked up and I saw a beautiful palace, a white room.
قال لي هذاك منزلك.
That's your house.
قال قلت لهما بارك الله فيكما فدراني فأدخله.
He said, the Prophet said, I said to them, بارك الله فيكما, let me enter it.
قال أما الآن فلا وأنت داخله.
As for now, but you will enter.
قال قلت لهما فإني رأيت منذ الليلة عجبا فما هذا الذي رأيت؟ قال أما إنا سنخبرك.
So at the end he said صلى الله عليه وسلم that I told them, as for tonight I saw amazing stuff. So what is it? So they told him, let's go, we will tell you.
أما الرجل الأول.
What's the first one?
I'm being cursed with the boulder.
With the boulder. Thank you.
Jazakallah khair.
So, أما الرجل الأول الذي أتيت عليه يثلب رأسه بالحجر
فإنه الرجل يأخذ القرآن فيرفضه وينام عن الصلاة المكتوبة.
That's for the first man. That his head is crushed with that boulder.
Right. It's enormous.
Before that person goes and brings, or the angel brings the boulder, the head of that person comes back to the normal state. It is a person that learns the Quran and he rejects it. And he sleeps when Salat comes. He does not wake up for Fajr. He does not pray the Isha before he goes to sleep. Just examples. May sleep at any Salat. But someone who sleeps at the time of Salat, he doesn't or she doesn't get up and pray, this is the result of that sin. This is the result of that sin.
وأما الرجل الذي أتيت عليه, the second one is
من بكبرت الواي.
Okay, جزاك الله خيرا. So الذي أتيت عليه يشرشر شدقه إلى قفاه ومنخره إلى قفاه وعينه إلى قفاه فإنه الرجل يغدو من بيته فيكذب الكذبة تبلغ الآفاق.
One that his face is cut, his mouth, his nose, his eye, from left to the right, and it's continuously, that punishment is continuous. If a person leaves his house to her house and they lie, they spread a lie, and it reaches the horizon, which means it's spreading, and especially nowadays. You just say something and don't worry about it being spread. Just type something, send it to one person, and the rest would be done by the shaitan and his workers, especially if it's a rumor or if it's a lie.
وَأَمَّا الرِّجَالُ وَالنِّسَاءُ الْعُرَاتُ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي مِثْلِ بِنَاءِ التَّنُورِ فَإِنَّهُ الزُّنَاتُ وَالزَّوَانِي وَالْعِنْبُ بِاللَّهِ.
And for the men that are in the oven, the men and the women, they are the adulterous man and the adulterous woman. Those who commit adultery or fornication, those are punished with a'yadu billah in those oven, and they are burning with the flames of the fire, and they have nowhere to go.
وَأَمَّا الرَّجُلُ الَّذِي أَتَيْتَ عَلَيْهِ يَسْبَحُ فِي النَّهْرِ وَيُلْقَمُ الْحِجَارَ فَإِنَّهُ آكِلُ الرِّبَى.
As for the one who is swimming the red river, and he is given stones or rocks into his mouth, is the person who eats, who takes interest or usury. The person who takes interest, puts his money in the bank, and he takes the profit from the money, not from the service or business. What's left?
Men, however.
So you just said it?
The man by the fire.
Okay, the one that is going around the fire and his smell is very bad.
وَأَمَّا الرَّجُلُ الْكَرِيهُ الْمَرْآةِ, this disgusted or ugly person. أَمَّا الْمَرْآةِ الَّذِي عِنْدَ النَّارِ يَحُشُّهَا وَيَسْعَى حَوْلَهَا, who is taking care of the fire and who is going around, فَإِنَّهُ مَالِكٌ خَازِنُ جَهَنَّمَ,
is the angels that is guarding the hillside. His name is Malik. And the guard of the Jannah is?
Ridwan
خازن الجنة ومالك خازن النار. The guard of the hellfire, the chief guard, is Malik.
وقالوا يا مالك ادعو لنا ربك أن خفف عنا من العذاب. وأما الرجل الطويل الذي في الروضة,
and the tall man that the Prophet couldn't see his face because of his height and the kids around him, is إبراهيم عليه السلام.
وأما الولدان الذين حوله فكل مولود مات على الشطة.
That's for the kids or babies that are around him, are those babies who are born and died.
And in another narration, ولد على الشطة فقال بعض المسلمين يا رسول الله وأولاد المشركين. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأولاد المشركين.
So the Prophet was asked, even the kids of those who are associated with Allah, disbelievers,
I said even those, because they were born upon the fitra, fitra instinct, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were born to worship, they haven't done anything yet. And of course, there's another explanation that they will be tested on the Day of Judgment. فِي ضَحْضَحٍ مِنَ النَّارِ Fire will be made and they will be ordered to throw themselves in the fire. If they throw themselves, which means they will have believed, they will have obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they will be saved from that fire. Or if they refuse to throw themselves, then they will be punished, وَعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ, because if they refuse, then when they saw everything, they would have refused in this life. وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ. وَأَمَّا الْقَوْمُ الَّذِينَ كَانُوا شَطْرٌ مِنْهُمْ حَسَنٌ وَشَطْرٌ مِنْهُمْ قَبِيحٌ فَإِنَّهُمْ قَوْمٌ خَلَطُوا عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَآخَرَ سَيِّئًا تَجَاوَزَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. The last type of people is yes, half and half. People with half nice looking half and ugly looking half. Those are people that خَلَطُوا عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَآخَرَ سَيِّئًا. They mixed between good and evil. They did righteous deeds, evil deeds, and they were almost even. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them. That's why when they went into that river, came back, all good looking, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave their sins. Their brothers and sisters in Islam. These things, mixing between good deeds and bad deeds, is our normal life. That's how our life is. One lives saying, obeying and disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the same time. We live sinning, but we have also to not to forget, to live repenting. So nothing of what we have been talking about will trap us, such as our hearts will be covered with the effects, the bad effects of the sin, and will not be listened from the reminders of Allah's crying out to Adam or the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So also the negative impact of the sins is that it will affect the earth. It affects the oceans. It affects the water by being contaminated or causing some diseases that never happened before. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ لِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Mischief has appeared in oceans and on the land because of the sin of people. Because of the sin of people. In Malachi 7:18, that's what people have done with their hands, which means the sin of people. So we taste from what we have done. So we may return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a reminder for us. If anything happens, contamination or diseases, or it's a reminder from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us, so we can return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance. And this is out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a calamity come upon us, it's a reminder from the last friend. We should not be doing what we are doing and go back and return to Him in repentance. And that's where the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lies, is that He doesn't want you to die like that on that sin. So He sent a calamity upon you so you wake up and return and return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so He forgives you. Also, and inshallah, I'll conclude with this to continue next time, inshallah, that whenever you see an earthquake or a volcano erupting or any landslide or anything like that, that is because of the sin of people. That's because of the sin of people. And when we see, subhanAllah, the barakah disappears from the food that we eat and the size of the food, even the size of human beings that is shrinking. Man, it's age by age, it's shrinking. Century by century, people are getting smaller and smaller and smaller. Adam alayhi salam was what?
I think it was
60 feet, right?
Right.
Adam alayhi salam was 60 feet tall. 60.
Soft as well.
6-0. What's 6? Zero is gone. 10 times. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has
said,
collected by Bukhari and Muslim, he said, خَلَقَ اللَّهُ آدَمَ وَطُولُهُ فِي السَّمَاءِ سِتُونَ ذِرَاعًا فَلَمْ يَزَلِ الْخَلْقُ يَنْقُصُ حَتَّى تَحْ. Allah, the Prophet said, yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created Adam alayhi salam 60 feet in the sky. And since then, human beings are shrinking and shrinking and shrinking until the day of judgment.
And so, like,
Malikum salam wa
rahmatullah.
So, brothers and sisters in Islam, as you've heard,
yes,
sin is not a little thing. It's seriously dangerous for us.
Yeah.
It has great negative impact on the earth, on the ocean, in the air, on the water, on our health, on our food, on the animals, on the sea and the fish, on the fish in the sea, on everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. Every creation of Allah is impacted by our sins as human beings. That's why, subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created mankind and jinn except to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sinning is not an option for us. However, we sin. But because of the ultimate mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we always have a chance to repent, as long as we live. So, we don't live in despair. We don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never. No matter what we do, how wrong we go, we don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us.
Well,
and accept our repentance. And in conclusion, I want to add something, inshallah. The Prophet ﷺ was repeatedly saying, Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayhi.
And just
repeatedly, excessively, I seek forgiveness in Allah and I repent to Him. Excessively, the Prophet
ﷺ.
What should be our attitude? Or what should be our jaydan as they come? It should be on our tongue. I seek forgiveness from Allah and I come to Him, so we are not cursed by the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we get a share from the dua of the angel that we share in that ayah in the beginning. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka at-tasri'u
al-mani.
Well, it's علينا innaka at-tawwab rahim. اللهم آت أنفسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ولا أصل. اللهم وسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيد الخلق أجمعين محمد النبي الكريم على آله وصحابته والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. جزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
All right.